I'm not either.
You know, it's four in English and in Spanish. Since President Trump has been the topic of today, I've got a question for the candidates. Do you agree with President Trump's recent decision to move the embassy to Jerusalem?
I'll take that. No.
Well, that's for everyone.
I'll take this. No, there is no upside to creating more destabilization in the region that's already destabilized and on the brink of open and armed conflict. We have enough problems over there as it is. What we do when we do those kinds of things is we ignite and incite conflict between and among citizens who we are attempting to broker to get along. The worst thing about that decision is, and I'm going to use a metaphor, if you are a referee, you cannot wear the same jersey as one team. At the behest of
the truth is that the capital of Israel was already decided by Congress several decades ago to be Jerusalem. Because of the tensions in the area, it hasn't been physically been moved, and that's understandable. But Israel is a sovereign country and one of our greatest allies, and does deserve to have the ability to determine the placements of its capital. All of its government offices are already in Jerusalem. Its heads of state are in Jerusalem. And I do agree with the decision to move the capital, or to move our physical embassy to Jerusalem. I do not agree with the way it was done. This rip the Band-Aid off approach, I do think is very destabilizing. But what you need to know about Israel is that the politics in Israel are as polarized as they are in the United States. Unfortunately, right now we have a Prime Minister of Israel who is as hawkish as the American President. And the two together, I do believe, are going to be very destabilizing for the region.
Yep. Free Palestine! Woo!
The United States can now be a neutral broker. And so we have essentially, I think, removed ourselves from that conversation. I think we can no longer say, as a country, that we want a two-state solution driven by the two states, because we have inserted ourselves this way. Something that was very troubling that surfaced during all of the news about this was the fact that the State Department had no idea. The State Department learned about this through the news, the way that we did. This, again, goes to the heart of the challenge with a president who cares little to nothing about ensuring that we have a healthy State Department and that we have strong diplomatic relations and that we are creating policy and making decisions based on the long term. That decision was made in order to please his base.
They're doing that, and the reason being is because Israel is its own independent state. We have no business meddling in their affairs. There is a fine line to draw there because the tensions are so high. But if we step back from the inception that this president became president, he wants to start war wherever it's possible. He incites people from different countries. So this is just another excuse for him to try to start a war, because I believe that this president is what he is looking for. So Israel is not the only thing, because it was unnecessary. It created chaos. This puts in harm's way Americans, and it will call us into conflict. We need Israel. We need to back them up because they are our ally. They are our first responders in the area. But we cannot meddle in their affairs. We need to be neutral, and we need to be able to back them up, but not decide for them. It just creates conflict that is unnecessary for Americans. Thank you.